So for our assessment, we're going to look to put a double set into a piece of steel conduit. Our double set needs to be about 75 mil from the bottom of the steel conduit to the back of the steel conduit. That gap generated there needs to be 75 mil. We are allowed plus or minus 5 mil from that measurement, and we're going to look at the technique required to try and put a double set in to a certain given dimensions in this video. I've cut my steel conduit approximately 600 millimeters long in length, and I've made a mark at 150 mil from one end. That's going to be the first bend I put into my steel conduit, and it's going to be approximately 45 degrees. I tend to err on the side of caution, be slightly less than 45 degrees, and then I turn it and pull the second bend in, and that's where the technique will come into play. So let's see how that works. So I'm going to look to put my first 45 degree bend in. I've set it up, I've got my 150 mil measurement and marked against the wheel of my conduit bending machine, and I'll pull my first one in slightly less than 45 for this technique. So we'll stick with that at less than 45 and we'll see how the next stage goes. So we've got it in, and now we're gonna take it, loosen it off and rotate it round. So we've got us pointing now with the 45 here, and we're gonna put the other one to bend it back to give us another horizontal plane against this plane. Okay, but it's the gap that we generate here, which is the technique we're trying to show in this video. We need to make sure that our conduit is straight and parallel going this way, it isn't rolled over, that it follows the line through, and then we've got to set this gap here. Okay, on site, no doubt the electrician would just pull the bend and it would fit perfectly first time because of his experience. We're going to try and show you a technique that can help you get it close to the 75 mil set that you require for the EAL assessment. So what we're going to do now is use, in this case, a hard ruler to set us a dimension off the wheel itself. So we're going to use it as a straight edge off the wheel and then work out whether I need to take my conduit through further into the machine, making the gap bigger, or put it back through the machine to make the gap smaller. Remembering the gap should be 75 mil for the assessment. Using this rule as a straight edge off the former, so it's laying against the former, we're going to use that to generate the position with which we can make our measurement. So at the moment, with them horizontal to each other, okay, we can see the gap there. If I want to make that gap bigger, I take the conduit and push in further and check that horizontal, that gap is now considerably bigger. Likewise, if I draw it back through the conduit bending machine, the gap when these are horizontal is obviously smaller. We're now going to set that gap to be 75 mil before bending the conduit back. So taking the measurement from the rule to the back of the conduit here, I've got about 55 at the moment with them horizontal, so I need to send the conduit further through into the machine itself. Measure it again. This time I'm approaching 75 mil, so I turn it around to try and show you I'm approaching there, 75 mil in that position there, thereabouts. We're gonna get some drift on the conduit bending machine when I pull it. Okay, so we're going to go, that's approximately 75 mil. This is horizontal to the conduit, the gap between there is approximately 75 mil. So we're going to now bend the second one in. So this surface and the bent new surface should run parallel with each other. I should normally nip round, keep looking as we go. I'll pull it and see where we are and we'll adjust it thereafter. So we're looking for this one and this one to be parallel. You're looking at it straight on, I'm looking at it from behind. So if we go for that to start with, and then we can see how we can adjust it. So we can see when we put it on the bench, we're fairly close. But what I've done is I've set the second piece that I've bent in the correct position, showing the first piece we've bent actually pointing down. That's not the case. We should be setting the first piece we got in the correct position. Okay, so that runs horizontal with the surface and looking at the second piece. When we go to re-bend steel conduit, we should always bend the last piece we bent again and not go back and rework the first piece. So when I look at that, it shows that I need to put a little bit more bend in here in order to sit that parallel with the bench itself. If I do a little measurement mark to start with, I'm about 75 already, so I'm not going to be far off, but this still needs a tiny little bit more bend in it in order to run the two surfaces parallel. Brought back over to the conduit bending machine, put it back in, and remember it's the second bend that we're going to adjust. It needed a little bit more bend putting in it. Okay, so I get to the stage where it's only a small amount of bend going. I say to myself, it's the weight of your arm, you're almost not going to feel it go in the corner, that you just get a little bit of bend in it. It's better to keep doing a couple of journeys backwards and forwards to see you've got it in, perhaps than over bend it and then struggle to pull the bend back out. So I'm just going to pull a tiny little bit more back in, and then we're going to stop and have a look and see where that works. So by putting a little bit more bend in the second bend, we've now got the two surfaces running horizontal. And when I measure here, I've got approximately 75 mil, okay, between that gap, okay, is what we're trying to get. I said 70 and 80, we're approximately at 75 using a technique using just two straight lines in order to work out where to pull the second bend. So we've managed to put our double set in our conduit. We've managed to get it to close to the 75 mil dimension required by the assessment. If I place it against the one on the wall, which is our template, please, we can see we're fairly close to the required dimensions according to the assessment itself. I'm not suggesting that technique is easy using two straight rules in order to create a set to a certain dimension, but it's one worth bearing in mind when you're playing around, especially when you're training, that at least it's a technique. Often people on site will pick up a piece of conduit, put two bends in it, and it will fit perfectly. You cannot teach that, so therefore I've come up with a ruler method in order to give you some chance of developing a set at a certain dimension.